Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Sunita Dole. The topic covered is joint relation, inner joint. SQL provides not only the basic Cartesian product mechanism for joining the tuples of the relation, but SQL also provides various other mechanisms for joining the relation, including condition joins and the natural joins, as well as various forms of the outer join. These additional operations are typically used as subquery expression in the from clause. Learning outcome: at the end of the session, students will be able to know about the join operation and write the query using inner join operation for given relation. In addition to the natural join, SQL provides other forms of the join operation, including the ability to specify an explicit join predicate and the ability to include in the result tuples that are excluded by the natural join. Join operations take two relations and return as a result another relation. These join operations are typically used as a subquery expression in the from clause. Each of the variants of the join operation in SQL consists of a join type and the join condition. Join condition defines which tuple in two relations match and what attribute are present in the result of the join. Join type defines how tuples in each relation that do not match any tuple in the other relation are treated. Table shows some of the allowed join types and the join condition. The first join type is the inner join and the other three are the outer joins. There are three join conditions, that is the natural, on and the using. The use of a join condition is mandatory for the outer join but is optional for the inner join. In inner join, if the join condition is omitted, a Cartesian product result. Syntactically, the keyword natural appears before the join type, whereas the on and the using condition appear at the end of the join expression. The keyword inner and the outer are optional since the rest of the join type deduce whether the join is an inner join or an outer join. The meaning of the join condition natural in terms of which tuple from the two relation match is straightforward. The order of the attribute in the result of the natural join is as follows. The join attribute, that is the attribute common to both the relation, appear first in the order in which they appear in the left hand side relation. Next come all the non-join attribute of the left-hand side relation and finally all non-join attribute of the right-hand side relation. The using clause is a form of natural join that only requires values to match on the specified attribute. The on condition allows a general predicate over the relation being joined. Like the using condition, the on condition appears at the end of the join expression. Consider inner join. In this visual diagram, the inner join returns the shaded area. The inner join would return the records where table 1 and table 2 intersect. Normal joins are called inner joins in the SQL. The keyword inner is, however, optional. The default join type is the inner join. Consider the relation for the queries on the inner join. Relation loan with the loan number, branch name and the amount. Relation borrower with the attribute customer name and loan number. In both relation, the common attribute is loan number. Here, borrower information is missing for L260 in the borrower relation and loan information is missing for L155 in the loan relation. Consider first the natural join. Relations loan and borrower. The query is select star from loan natural join borrower. The natural join operation requires that for a loan tuple and a borrower tuple to match. Result is given on the slide. The attribute of the result consists of the attribute of the left hand side relation followed by the attributes of the right hand side relation. Hence, the result contains loan number, branch name and amount, attribute of the left hand side relation, loan and the customer attribute of the right hand side relation borrower. Now consider the inner join using the natural join condition. So relations, loan and borrower. The query for the inner join using natural join condition is select star from loan natural inner join borrower. This expression computes the natural join of two relations. The only attribute name common to the loan and borrower is the loan number. The result is shown on the slide. The natural join is equivalent to the natural inner join. Hence, the result of the natural join and the natural inner join is same. Consider the inner join using on join condition. So the relation loan and the borrower. Query is select star from loan inner join borrower on loan dot loan number equals to borrower dot loan number. The on condition above specifies that a tuple from loan matches a tuple from the borrower if their loan number values are equal. The result has the loan number attribute listed twice in the join result, once for the loan and once for the borrower, even though their loan number values must be the same. The SQL standard does not require attribute name in such results to be unique. The as clause should be used to assign the unique name to the attribute in the query and the subquery result. We can rename the second occurrence of loan number to the customer loan number. The orderings of the attribute in the result of the join is important for renaming. Consider the inner join using join condition. Relation loan and borrower. The query is select star from loan inner join borrower using loan number. The result is shown on the slide. The result has loan number attribute listed only once in the join result. Till now, we consider the inner join using join condition natural, on and the using. Now pause this video and reflect on this question for a minute or 2 minutes and write your response. Once you return the answer to this question, then you can restart playing this video. The question is, write the queries for the inner join using natural, on and using condition along with the result. For this question, consider two relations, the employee relation with the attribute employee name, street and the city, and the employee salary relation with the employee name, branch name and the salary. Here, salary information is missing for the employee Smith in the employee salary relation, and the employee information is missing for the Gate employee in the employee relation. I hope all of you have completed this activity. Consider the following relations, employees and employee salary. So first consider the inner join using natural condition. The query is select star from EMP natural inner join EMP salary. The result is shown in the table. The common attribute employee name appears only once. Now consider the inner join using on condition for the following relations. The query is select star from EMP inner join EMP salary on EMP dot employee name is equal to EMP salary dot employee name. The result is shown on the slide, which contains the common attribute employee name twice. Now consider the inner join using condition for the following relation. The query is, select star from EMP inner join EMP salary using in parenthesis employee name. Result contain the common attribute employee name only once. Here on this slide, queries for inner join using natural, on and using condition along with the results are given. The results using the join condition natural and using are same, in which the common attribute employee name appears only once. In join condition on, the common attribute employee name appears twice. These are the references used for preparing this presentation. Thank you.